get any company these days. There are never any visitors. There's no games, no parties, no fun, no anything. By royal command of Her Majesty the Queen. That's the Queen. You must always watch out for her. She's cold and evil. Her eyes flash with dreadful fires. Her heart is as black as coal, and she has no soul. It's true. All she has is her beauty, her riches, her power, and me. I am the mirror. I am the magic spirit of the mirror. I can tell the past, the present, and the future to whoever asks the question, but no one asks me anything anymore, except the Queen. Every day she asks, there, do you hear her? She's coming. She's coming! Quick! Hide! Get down! Don't let her see you! She will! Beware the Queen! Beware the Queen!
Well, 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 another day. Another day, and once more I have shown my power to all who question me. There are none more powerful than I, none with as large a kingdom, and none as beautiful. Tell me, Mirror, am I not truly beautiful, the most beautiful woman of all women? Right. Mirror shining, mirror bright, mirror glowing in the night. I command you by all the powers of hell, heed my words and obey my spell. Answer the questions that I desire or burn forever in a ball of fire.
In truth, my queen, there is no one in the kingdom as lovely as you. There are none to compare with your beauty.
Good. It is as I thought. But you, you'll have to learn to answer more quickly. It's no easy task to be a queen, especially an evil queen. There are times when I seriously consider going to some other line of work. Too bad the king isn't alive. He could help me.
Well, yes, he could.
But you poisoned him. Your Majesty.
Oh, come now. You can't expect me to remember such trivia, can you? Besides, I have more important things on my mind right now. There are spies in my kingdom.
No.
Yes, spies. Who dislikes me enough to actually send spies against me?
That depends. How many people do you know?
Silence! You should learn your lesson. You can always be replaced by a parrot.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know anyone was in here.
No, no, it's quite all right, Snow. Come in a moment. Stay a moment or two if you wish. Surely you can spare a moment or two for even your own mother.
Stepmother?
Don't get technical with me, Snow. I get very upset. You do recall what happened the last time I got upset, don't you?
Yes. You turned my teacher into a hamster.
And a good thing it was, too. I mean, oh, goodness. I mean, really, Snow, what does a girl like you need with knowledge anyway? You're never going to be important. I mean, just look at you. Look at the way you're dressed.
Oh, but I haven't had any new clothes for 3 years.
Don't bother me about new clothes. I have more serious things on my mind right now. You haven't seen anyone skulking about the castle lately now, have you?
No, just Bertrand.
Bertrand? What Bertrand?
My teacher. The one you turned into a hamster.
Oh, I'm sorry I ever asked. You're dismissed, Snow. I said you could go.
Oh, Your Majesty, you see, I really would like a new dress. Tomorrow is my birthday.
Is it really?
Yes, Your Majesty, I shall be 16.
Oh, well, that is rather special. I'll think about your request.
Oh, thank you, Your Majesty.
I just finished thinking. The answer is no.
Has anyone ever told you you are a really rotten person?
Flattery will get you nowhere, Mirror, but as long as we are on the subject.
Here we go again.
Silence! Concentrate your powers, sharpen your eyes, and quicken your wits. And tell me again. Mirror, mirror, on my wall, who is the fairest of them all?
In truth, my queen, There is no one in the entire world as lovely as you.
Good. That's the way it always has been and the way it always will be.
All things may change, Your Majesty.
Never. This will never change, Mirror. If I ever found out there was another lovelier than I'd have her killed. Immediately. And if you know what's good for you, you'll never again mention that possibility to me. Never. Or I'll smash you into 1,000 pieces, and as long as you're trapped inside this frame, whatever happens to you, do I make myself quite clear?
Yes, Your Majesty. Clear as glass.
Good. Now I must leave. I have a spy to catch. It's suspicious in the castle, report it to me immediately.
I shall.
For your sake? I certainly hope so.
Boy, is she mad! I mean, do you think it was something I said?
No.
We're lucky there aren't more like her in the kingdom. Most of the people are good and kind, and the kindest and gentlest of all the people in the land are the Seven Dwarfs. Those are the Seven Dwarfs. Their names are Grumpy, Sneezy, and Dopey. Happy,
hiya.
Doc,
hiya.
Sleepy, and Bashful. And they have lived in the forest for as long as anyone can remember. No one knows how they got there or where they came from. Not even me. And I know everything. Almost everything.
All right, everyone, hurry up. It's time for work. Can't you see the sun's up?
The what?
The sun. That's the sun.
Yeah, well, where is the mother?
No, it's not a son.
It's a son.
Right. Boy, and I thought I was dopey.
Hey, Doc, can I ask you a question?
Would it make any difference if I said no?
Nope.
Then go right ahead.
Well, I've been talking to the rest of you. We all think this is pretty dopey.
He certainly is.
No, not him. What I mean is, why should we go off to the mine every day when we can't find any gold anymore?
But there is gold there, Grumpy. There always has been, and there always will be. It's a magic mine.
Maybe so, but there's a spell on the mine. I'll bet the queen's behind it.
Now, Grumpy,
I don't think you should get so upset over all this.
Upset? Upset? Everyone's upset.
Oh, come now.
I'll show you. Happy, are you upset?
Oh, there, buddy. I'm upset crazy.
Can't trust anybody these days.
Well, you're upset, aren't you?
Yes,
I'm very upset. Upset. I'm very upset.
Well,
give me a chance. Bashful.
I don't really want to get involved.
Sneezing.
Achoo! Oh, it's terrible. This cold is driving me around the fence.
Oh, nuts. Dopey.
What?
Are you upset?
About what?
Oh, never mind. I'm not sure I started all this anyway.
Right. So now, if you're quite finished, I think it's time you were off. Isn't that right? Well,
all right, I'll go, but I don't have to like it.
That's good enough for me. Come along, gang. We're off to the mine.
To the mine!
Than the queen herself. So bam! On goes a spell and it'll only end with her destruction. Now. Oh, if the dwarves knew this for sure, why they'd be in a flash to fight for their gold. But they'd be destroyed in an instant. Oh, if only there was someone powerful enough to oppose the queen. Someone smart enough and brave enough and strong enough. What was that? Oh, someone's coming. Quick, hide, get down. Don't let them see you.
somewhere. Come on, Will. If you were about to attack papers, to help seek a plans, to war on your father's kingdom, where would you be?
Try the second room.
No, 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 they wouldn't be there. They gotta be somewhere more dangerous. Like in the belly of a dragon. Or the darkest, dankest dungeon here at this castle. Castle. I hope I'm at the right castle.
I better check the map.
Excuse me. I say hello there. Pardon me, but what are you doing?
Doing? Oh, you mean what I'm doing here?
Yes, that's generally what I had in mind.
Mice. I'm looking for mice.
I'm afraid I don't believe you.
You don't?
No.
Are you calling me a liar?
Yes, I am, and I must warn you. I'm a magic mirror. I can make you tell me the truth.
Yeah, sure you can.
Can. What's your name?
Prince Williams.
Well, Prince Williams. What would a prince from the next kingdom be doing here in the queen's castle dressed as one of the queen's huntsmen? Could you be a spy?
No! Yes! All right, you got me. I'm a spy. But not a very good one. I tried to tell my father, the king, but he wouldn't listen. No, he said, my boy, if you're to prove yourself worthy of inheriting my crown and my kingdom, you must prove yourself strong and brave and deserving. So here I am, dressed in these stupid clothes, caught and packed the first day of my job. You gonna turn me in?
I'm thinking it over, but you don't need to worry about being turned into a...
She would.
No, but how do you feel about being turned into a... groundhog?
I knew it. Should have gone to summer camp when I had the chance.
Oh, you needn't worry so soon, Prince William. I didn't say I was gonna tell her, did I?
You mean you're not?
No, I wouldn't tell the queen a thing.
But why?
I have my reasons.
Hey, thank you. That's great. Thank you so much. Really.
Just a minute, Prince Williams. There is still one thing we need to settle.
I knew there's a catch in there somewhere.
You must promise me that when the time comes, you will do exactly what I tell you to do.
But what will I have to do?
You'll find out.
But when will the time come?
You'll know when it happens.
Know when it happens? I don't even know what I'm doing here.
You're a spy, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Well, do I have your promise or don't I?
I'm not sure yet.
Well, I'm pretty sure there are worse things than being turned into a groundhog, but I can't think of any.
All right, I'm sure. I'll do whatever you say.
Good. Now, if I need you, I'll summon you. But until that time, you must never return to this room. Do I make myself clear?
Very clear.
Excellent. Now go before the queen comes back and make sure you're neither seen nor heard.
I know. I'm not a complete fool.
It's that way. Yeah. And he's going to be king. With someone like that, why bother fighting a war? He'll fight it from the inside out. But, you know, perhaps tomorrow there'll be a sign. Maybe tomorrow, the day of Snow White's 16th birthday. How beautiful.
Flowers. And I love you too, Forrest. So peaceful. It's good to be alive! I guess I'm not really alone after all. I have all of you, trees! The flowers, the birds, and the animals. That's all I really need. But I'll tell you something, Forrest. I'm waiting for something to happen, something marvelous, but I don't even know what it is. How strange. Who's there? I said, who's there?
This is me. Me. I was just passing by.
Your clothes. Are you one of my stepmother's?
time I checked. Things change so rapidly these days. As I was saying, I was just passing by and I heard you talking. I came to see what was going on.
You heard me?
Mostly.
Oh, you must think me silly, talking to all these trees.
No, I don't. It just shows you care.
Oh, good. It's nice to know that somebody else understands. Oh, so, you come here often?
No, I'm still pretty new around the castle.
Oh, where are you from?
I'm from the next... I travel a lot.
Oh, can I go with you? The next time you go on one of your travels, I won't be a bother, I promise, and I don't eat much.
Listen, you're a really nice girl, and I would love to take you with me, but I can't. Besides, I don't even know your name.
Oh, I'm Snow White.
Snow White, the Queen's stepdaughter.
Yes, I'm afraid so.
I shouldn't be talking to you. If I'm seen, I'm gonna be turned into a chicken or something.
Please, don't go. No one ever talks to me, ever. Besides, the forest isn't always a safe place.
That is silly. It was just an owl. None of the forest creatures can hurt you, not this close in the castle.
Oh, are you sure?
I'm positive. There's nothing to be afraid of. On second thought, I could be wrong. I could be very wrong.
Eloise, I have to go in now, otherwise I'll miss my own birthday party. Some party. No one gives or gets any presents, ever. My stepmother thinks it's frivolous. Everyone just sits around and talks.
Here. It's not much, but it's the best gift I can give. Happy birthday.
Snow White!
I'm coming, Eloise!
And once more, everyone in the world has aged a little and lost more of their beauty. Everyone except me, that is. Isn't that right, Mirror? Mirror, mirror on my wall, who is the fairest of them all?
You are not gonna like this.
Never mind the predictions, Mirror. I command you to tell me. Who is the fairest of them all?
In truth, my queen, you are still possessed of a face as fair as the morning sky. But there is someone who surpasses you in beauty and loveliness.
What? How dare you say such a thing to your queen, you wretched little slab of glass?
I told you you weren't gonna like this.
Well, who is it? Do tell, Mirror. Who could possibly be more lovely than I? More beautiful, tell me.
It's Snow White, Your Majesty.
Snow White. Please, the girl's just a child.
No, my queen. Today is Snow White's 16th birthday. And she is a woman. A woman far more beautiful than you. The loveliness of her face and heart shine like the sun.
Snow White! How could she do this to me? How dare she? I have been stabbed in the back! I will not stand for this.
You can always sit down.
Silence! There's nothing worse than a big-mouthed mirror. No, something must be done. I have it. Huntsman, send in my best huntsman, and be quick about it.
Send in the best huntsman!
Send in the best huntsman!
Send in the best huntsman!
He's not here?
He's not here!
He's not here!
He's not here!
All right, send in the second best huntsman then. Goodness, it's so hard to get good help these days.
Send in the second best huntsman!
Send in the second best!
Second best!
Oh, wait, that's me?
Yes, you stupid!
I'm coming?
He's coming!
He's coming!
Well.
Oh, sorry.
Well, that's better. You are rather new to the castle, aren't you?
Oh, yes, very new, Your Majesty.
And tell me, are you loyal to your ruler?
Oh, yes, very loyal, Your Majesty.
Well, would you do whatever I asked you to do?
Of course, Your Majesty.
Well, would you do it without question, without hesitation, and in absolute secrecy?
Of course, Your Majesty.
Look, you're going to hurt yourself if you keep bouncing up and down all the time, and we don't want that now, do we? Besides, I have a mission for a man of bravery, cunning, and physical strength.
Yes.
I mean you, you twit!
Sorry.
Tonight, long after the sun has set, but before the moon rises to illuminate the evening sky, I want you to take Snow White into the forest.
Take Snow to forest?
Yes.
I bet you wish to show her a new bird you found, one that only comes out at night.
Just be absolutely certain that you are not seen. Oh, and speak of this to absolutely no one.
Tell no one.
Correct. Then, once you have her outside, take her to a quiet part of the forest and kill her. Make it look like the work of some wild animal.
And kill Snow White. Kill Snow White?
Kill Snow White. Didn't you hear what I said? Didn't you understand me?
Oh, I heard you all right. But to kill Snow White, what crime has she committed?
Are you questioning my orders?
Is there anyone else in the room?
Silence! I will not tolerate weakness. If you need an explanation, chalk it up to national security. I don't care, just do it. And to be absolutely certain that you complete the task, I want you to bring me her heart when you've finished.
Her heart?
Am I living in a castle of echoes? Must I repeat everything that I say?
No.
Good. Then complete the task and speak of this to no one. There, what have you to say to that, Mirror? Very well, be silent. The only thing that I care about is that tomorrow you tell me that I am the most beautiful woman in all this kingdom. That's all I care about now, and that's all I will ever care about.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Good. Now, huntsman, here's a golden dagger. Use it well and skillfully.
I will.
You'd better.
Kill Snow White! Kill Snow White! I couldn't live with myself if I did that. But if I don't, I won't have to worry about living myself because I'll be dead. No matter what I choose, I lose. What am I gonna do?
Have you considered going into real estate?
That is no answer!
That is no question! You'll know what to do as it needs to be done. I mean, trust me, have I ever let you down?
Well, you've never advised me before.
Never mind. Just go before the queen comes back. Things are starting to get interesting around here. Personally, I can't wait until our friend meets Snow White in the forest. Between the time of the setting sun and the rising moon.
Certainly not.
You know, ever since I first met you, I've always admired your bravery and your strength.
You have.
Uh-huh. I know that I'll come to no harm as long as you are here. But that's enough. Can I see that bird's nest now?
The what?
The bird, the one your note said I'd like to see. Oh, look! Do you see it? Can you make it out? Is it the one you were telling me about?
Snow White.
Oh, it's so beautiful. What is it? Why is your dagger drawn? Is there some danger coming this way?
I can't do it.
What's wrong, Huntsman? What can't you do?
Stay away for your own sake.
I don't understand. What's wrong?
Listen to me, Princess. You have to run as far and as fast as you can.
But why? What's happened?
Now that you're 16 years old, you're more beautiful than the Queen, and she's ordered you to death. I'm supposed to kill you.
My death?
Yes. Now go, run. We still have time to escape.
But wait, what will you do when she finds out that I'm still alive? She'll do something terrible to you.
I'll chop and kill an animal. I'll take its heart to her, and she won't look for you. While the Queen lives, you must never return to the castle. Do you understand?
Yes, I think so.
Then go, and beware the Queen!
Snow White ran all that night, never looking back for an instant and never slowing down. She ran through the haunted swamps and the forest of living trees and past all of the terrible and deadly things that lived in the enchanted forest. She ran and ran until at last, too tired to run any further, she came to the cottage of the seven dwarves. But when she arrived, she found the cottage empty.
The dwarves were still at their mine working.
She looked everywhere. She looked high and low and low and low. Dwarves being short as they are. But she couldn't find anyone. Finally, exhausted, feeling lost and alone, she collapsed underneath the beds and fell immediately to sleep. And yet, as she slept, the prince returned to the castle with what he hoped the queen would believe to be Snow White's heart.
Something serious, I'm sure. Any enemy of the queen is a friend of ours. Oh,
thank you. You're very kind. I just wish I knew what to do next, where to go. Where can I go that is safe from my evil stepmother?
If you wish, you can stay with us, Snow White.
Yeah! Stay with us, Snow White! We'll protect you!
Sure! Stay with us, Snow White!
Wait a minute!
What is it, Grumpy?
I don't think this is such a great idea. After all, the queen is very powerful, and she has all these kinds of spells, and... I mean, it could be very dangerous, and... We... us... Can you cook?
Why, yes!
Then you can stay.
Riding high in the sky, there's not a cloud to be seen. Now that I have Snow White's heart in this box, I am once more the loveliest woman in all this kingdom. Would you not agree, Mirror?
How about a weather report, Your Majesty?
Mirror.
You know, it should be slightly warmer today. Also, just a little bit drier with a southerly blowing wind coming in from the south.
Mirror, I asked you a question.
I know.
I said, am I not the most beautiful woman in all of this kingdom?
Oh, I know what you asked. I just can't answer you.
Cannot or will not?
I will not.
Rebellion, is it? I warn you, you have exactly 5 seconds to answer my question, or I will shatter your glass and send you into empty space for the rest of time.
You wouldn't. You couldn't.
I would, I could, and I will, if you don't answer me. You have 2 seconds, Mirror.
Oh, but I can't.
Goodbye, Mirror.
No. I'll answer. You are not the most beautiful woman in the kingdom.
What? That's impossible. Snow White is...
Snow White lives! She is with the 7 dwarves who have sworn to protect her against you. They don't have your spells or your magic, but... they can resist you because they have a courage that cannot be defeated. You have failed, my queen.
You. That is impossible unless the huntsman.
Yes.
The huntsman, he lied to me. How dare he? I will not be lied to. No, I have not failed. Not. Bring me the head of the huntsman! Now!
Bring in the head of the huntsman!
Bring in the head of the huntsman!
Bring in the head of the huntsman!
I mean, he's
not here!
He's not here!
He's not here!
He's not here!
Well, find him! Find him and bring me his head! I will take his head and put it atop the castle for the hawks and the vultures to play with. Oh, but I should have known better than to trust him. I can't trust anyone in this castle. It's crawling with spies! Deal with Snow White myself. But how? That's it. That's it, a living death. A sleep that will endure for all time. Oh, that's it.
Do you see this mirror? This is a potion
made from the dust of the floor of Hades. It will allow me to transform myself into whatever form I desire. Well, certainly there are drawbacks. For instance, in these other forms, I will have only a few of my true powers. But I won't need much to deal with Snow White. And this potion should leave just enough for 3 changes, and enough to change me back when the deed is done. Yes. Now to put an end to Snow White. Forever.
Oh, don't look at me like that. I know. I betrayed Snow White, but I have to, don't you see? Part of the magic is that I can only tell the truth. Oh, if only there was something I could do, but I can't. I'm a prisoner in this glass. The only way I could ever be free is if someone traded place with me and entered the mirror the second I left it. But no one would ever want to do that, because then they'd be trapped for all time, just like me. All I can do, all we can do, is watch. Watch and hope for poor Snow White Girl.
Say, Snow White, do you think you could help me with this?
Oh, I think lots of help.
Do I put my right foot?
Yes. No.
Oh, my other right.
There you go. Oh. There you go. All good and snug?
Yep.
Oh, good. Now then, is everyone all set?
Yep.
Yeah, suppose so. You guys see no sense in it. All right then, gang. To the mine!
To the mine!
After her. And you be careful, Snow White.
I will, Doc.
Good. And remember, don't let anyone in after we leave. Understand?
I understand.
All right, then. Come on, Sleepy, it's time to go.
No, 5 more minutes.
No, come on.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Snow White.
Bye, Snow White.
So, there it is. The cottage of the seven dwarves. And no one at home but Snow White. Oh, how convenient. Makes things so much easier for me. And my little potion. Goodbye, my dear. It's getting late, and I still have so much to do.
Goodbye, and do come back. I'd so like to see you again.
Oh, you will. You will.
What a nice girl. It's such a lovely box. I'm sure it must have been terribly expensive. I wonder how it sounds. How pretty. I don't know.
Who wants some cherry pie tonight?
Well, we don't have any cherry pie left. Hey, Jack! We don't even have any cherries.
I know that. What do you think I am anyways? Don't get cute. We'll just have to find someone to pick some cherries for us.
Who on earth would want to go into the woods after dark?
Alone.
Unarmed.
The monsters all around?
Who could possibly be that dumb?
Dobby!
What did I do?
Nothing at all. Why, we thought we'd give you the honor of picking some cherries for us for tonight. Would you like that?
Aww, sure thing. Yum, sounds like fun.
Well?
Well, what?
Get going!
Be Snow White! Where are you?
Okay, quit hiding.
Snow White!
Where's
Snow
White?
Where did she go?
Snow
Crystal!
Red!
Well, just don't stand there. Do something!
How can I do anything when I don't even know what's wrong with her? I got them! I got the cherries! See? I'm so dumb!
Someone's at the door.
Oh, well, shouldn't we see who it is?
Just a moment.
Who's there?
Just an old peasant woman looking for a drink of water, kind sir.
Peasant woman? I'll bet.
Oh, please. I've been walking in the hot sun all
Go right ahead.
My bones are so weary after all that walking.
We understand. We're pretty tired ourselves.
Is that so? Busy working?
Not exactly. Oh, we're trying to catch the evil queen.
No, what for?
She tried to put us under her spell.
But I saved us, and Snow White too.
Yep, if it wasn't for him, we'd all be in terrible trouble.
I'll certainly remember that.
Did you catch the queen?
Well, we gave her a good chase.
So you saw her?
No, not exactly.
But word has it she's up with the ugliest woman in the kingdom. Why, you insolent!
I mean, how interesting. How very interesting.
Yes. Now that you've finished your water, you may as well be on your way. It's getting pretty dark.
Thank you for your hospitality. But I've forgotten something. I've forgotten to pay you.
That's all right.
I don't have any silver or gold.
Forget it.
But I do have this rather large diamond.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll take that.
See how it sparkles in the sunlight?
It's very beautiful.
It is. Why don't you come closer?
Bashful's right. It's beautiful. It just seems to hold your eye.
Almost as if it doesn't even
hold. No. It does have that effect, so I'm told.
It makes you feel drowsy. Like waves on a sleepy sea. A soft, quiet, sleepy sea.
Strange. I feel so tired.
Same.
That's it. Tired. You want to sleep. Yes. Sleep. Sleep. Sleep.
Asleep? How rude. How terribly rude. Have you nothing to say? Good. Now I have you all under my spell until I decide to release you. And I will never release any of you.
That's all I needed to hear.
Now, release my friends.
This is impossible. You're asleep. You must be. Why doesn't my spell work on you?
It's an old woman.
Or should I say, my queen. Your spell makes people who are awake
sleepy, but as they are.
You're sleepy.
Right? Wide awake for once without hair service.
Please go white the rest of the floor.
All right, all right, all right. Spell of darkness, spell of night, leave this place in fearful flight. Awaken, awaken, awaken.
Oh my.
She did it to us again, and we fell for it. We're so, achoo! Stupid.
No, stupid is my cousin. He didn't have anything to do with this.
Are you all right, Snow White?
Yes. It was so strange. I mean, I could hear everything that was going on, but I just couldn't seem to move.
Same here.
Me too.
It was Sleepy that saved us.
She sure did. That was a brave thing to do, Sleepy. Sleepy, where is Sleepy?
Here she is.
And she's sleeping.
Figures.
Well, we can't just leave her there. We've all got to get out of here. The cottage isn't safe anymore.
Where can we go, Doc?
There's only one place we can go.
The mine. She'll never find us there.
Yeah, Doc's right. Give her one. Let's go.
No.
Right.
That night, when the queen returned to the cottage, she found that the dwarves had left. It didn't take her long to figure out where they were, however. She spent all that night in the forest, plotting and planning. Finally, she got an idea. Picking an apple from a nearby tree, she coated one half in a terribly poisonous potion. The other half, she left untouched. She then set off for the mine of the Seven Dwarves.
Doc, why do you come here every day?
Because we believe. And we will never stop believing in the mine.
No matter what happens, it's always important to believe in something, Snow White.
Besides, we didn't have anything else to do.
Dopey?
Yeah, Doc?
You are not helping.
All right, let's get to work, everyone.
Would you like to see how we look for gold, Snow White?
Could I?
Sure thing.
Snow White.
Now, Snow White. Now I will take care of you forever. Now I will take care of you forever.
Did you hear something? I thought I heard a noise. Oh, well, it must have been my imagination. Nothing bad can happen, not today. It's such a lovely day.
Yes, it is. Isn't it?
Oh, who's there?
Just an old apple seller, young lady. Just a harmless old apple seller.
An apple seller?
Yes, my lovely. And I seem to have gotten lost. Could you possibly direct me towards the castle?
I don't think I should.
Oh, come now. You don't mean you're afraid of me, do you?
No, of course not. I'm not afraid.
Good, good. Because I wouldn't harm anyone. I'm just a tired old woman selling apples.
But what are you doing selling apples in a forest?
My dear young friend, there are no apple trees in the city. How am I to sell apples there?
Whereas here, in the forest,
there are apples everywhere. It just makes matters so much easier for me.
Well, I guess that makes sense.
Of course it does. Now, about the castle?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. It's north of here. 2, maybe 3 miles?
I believe I can see it now.
What a relief.
And I have you to thank for setting me straight. Could I possibly repay your kindness with a gift?
No. Thank you. I've had my share of gifts.
Oh, come now. It's just an apple. It's quite harmless.
Oh, that's easy for you to say, but how can I be sure? For all I know, there might be poison on it or something.
Poison? Oh, come. Who would be that wicked to put poison on an apple?
I can think of one or two.
I just bet you could. But here, let me show you that this apple is quite harmless. Deep, harmless, and quite delicious. Have a bite.
Well,
go on.
All right, just one.
But it's bitter.
Bitter? Oh, no, no. From this day on, you shall sleep as though dead for 1,000 years. 1,000 years!
What's that noise? Who's there?
Snow White!
Well, Doc,
we're too late. She's dead. Snow White is dead. It's the Queen. She did it.
Thank you. only true love's kiss can awaken Snow White now, and I am the only one who will ever know that. Ah! This is glorious, is it not, Mirror?
If you say so, Your Majesty.
Oh, it is, but now to regain my true shape and form, so I may save all my finer victory all the more.
But where is it? Where is mine? Where is mine?
Where is what, Your Majesty?
You know perfectly well what I'm looking for, Mirror.
No, honestly, I have no idea.
I am looking for my potion, you fool!
Oh.
Without it, I'll be trapped half in, half out of this hideous, hunched form the rest of my life!
You mean this potion?
Yes, that potion. Now give it to me. This instant.
If you want it, take it from me.
You've given me enough trouble as it is. Now, to put an end to you once and for all.
So lovely.
Bury her?
No.
Never. She will lie here in peace with the flowers and the trees she loved so much in life. We will build a palace here for her to rest in. It's the least we can do for her now that she's...
dead?
Who's there? Who's there? Who are you?
Brother Snow White, we've come to help.
Well, you've come too late, for she's gone. You may approach.
Lovely, is she not?
She is. I just can't believe that she's gone. Would you mind if I had a moment with her alone?
I thought you'd never ask.
Ever since I first saw you, Snow White, I knew I was in love with you, as I've never been in love before. Oh. Ever since the night we've parted, I've searched the land for you. Oh. And now, I've found you. But too late.
No.
So now, all I can give you is my love, in one final kiss.
To bring you back to my kingdom.
Yay!
Aren't they a lovely couple? When they return to the prince's kingdom, they will be married. But
dwarves will find their gold restored once again in their mine, and you guessed it, everyone lives happily ever after. Almost everyone.